Hey folks, let's take a look at how we can deploy a subquery project to the subquery hosted solution, namely called SubQuery Project. First of all, let's go to the project link on the subquery homepage, and I'm going to show you what we are trying to achieve. You can see I've got a project here already, so let's open this. Then I'll jump into the Explorer. And in the playground here, I'm going to hit the run, and you'll see data being returned. So this is what we are trying to do. We're trying to get a project into this hosted solution platform and run our query. So the first thing we want to do is take our project and make sure it's in our GitHub repository, because the project is going to pull the code from this repository. So there are two ways you can do this. You can go ahead and create or upload your own project to your repo, or what I'm going to do is jump into the SubQuery GitHub repository, and I'll pick a repository to copy. I'm going to pick one with the prefix of tutorial, and you can pick any one of these if you want. I'm going to choose the account transfer one. So let's go ahead and copy this by clicking on the fork. And it's going to ask me, where do I want to fork this to? Let's go my repository. And there we have it. So now let's jump into SubQuery Project. And note that I have already logged in. So if I haven't logged in already, you'll notice that it will ask me to log in with my GitHub credentials. And if you're doing this for the first time, it'll need authorization doing what's called the OAuth dance. So I've already done this, so it's going to log me straight in. And just a quick note that at the top here, if you are using your organizational GitHub repository instead of your personal one, you can select it in here as well. And if I go back to the documentation here, just referring back to publishing a project, you can see here on the right-hand side, adding a GitHub organization account, because it's actually very common to publish your project under the name of your GitHub organization rather than a personal account. So it's in this drop-down where you can change it. And of course, you do need to connect it first of all. So I've logged in as my personal account, which is fine. And then the next thing I do is click Create Project. Now I get a few fields that I need to fill out. Of course, let's go from the top to bottom. The project name, I'll call it, say, Account Transfer. The subtitle, let me go into the repo here. Let's call it a one-to-many example. Copy this. I'll spell that correctly. And then in my description, I'll go ahead and maybe copy this whole sentence here out. Now note, if I copy this above here, I'm going to exceed the 100 character limit. Just something of interest there. And let me fix the spelling here. And then I'll select the GitHub repo. And I'll also click here to upload a logo, just to make it nice and tidy. And note that the description and the name and subtitle, these are used for marketing purposes and SEO as well. So it's ideal to have this as descriptive and as accurate as possible. Now, as mentioned in previous videos as well, if I select this here, it hides it from the public SubQuery Explorer, meaning that in Explorer here, I won't actually see the project. But in my case, I'm happy to make this public, so I'll leave it unticked, and then I'll hit Create Project. Now, once I do this, you'll see that I've got the title, the subtitle here, the description all displayed, the GitHub repository. But the note here says I have to deploy my project first before SubQuery is able to index my data. I've got what's called a production slot and a staging slot. You can think of your staging slot as like a development environment for you to do some testing. However, and this is important to note, you want to do all your unit testing on your local host first, so on your laptop. Once it's passed and you're happy, you can deploy it to a staging slot and then use this for, say, integration or systems testing before promoting it to production. You don't really want to do your unit testing in a staging slot. So what I'm going to do here is click on deploy, and then I get a whole bunch of options available to me. I can go ahead and commit the latest version, which is this one here, or you can see I've got older versions as well. So I've got a choice. I'll go ahead and make this the latest version. I can then go ahead and override various endpoints. So this project is using the default Polkadot mainnet endpoint, and we can check this by going into the GitHub repository here and looking at our project YAML file. And you can see it's consuming the Polkadot API here. But what I'm going to do is show you how I can overwrite this with, say, a Kusama endpoint. I can also override the dictionary endpoint here. So this code here is using a dictionary. And if you're not sure what this is, I'll demonstrate this when I deploy the project, because it allows you to make your indexing a lot quicker by only grabbing the data that you need. There's actually more information on a dictionary in the documentation, if I can find it, where on the left-hand side here, you can see how does a subquery dictionary work, and it goes into the inner workings, so I highly recommend reading this as well. I'll leave the dictionary blank, allowing the project to use the default. And then down below here, I've got some previous versions of the indexer that I can choose from, as well as the query engine. For both of these, I'll leave it as the latest version. And quite often, this is the recommendation as well. Unless, of course, you're writing some code for a specific older version. So let's go ahead and deploy this. And this will take a minute or two, because in the back end, the hardware, the environment is being provisioned automatically. The CPUs, the virtual machine, it's all being created. So sit back, relax, and catch you in a few. Okay, so you can see now that the staging slot is up and running. So the options we have here are, we can promote to production, deploy a new version, view this on SubQuery Explorer, or we can also delete the project as well. So let's go ahead and view this on SubQuery Explorer. And you can see that it's starting to synchronize the blocks, so from 180 to 210. And we've got quite a way to go. Down below, you can see the network that it's connected to. So it's Kusama, because we overrode the default, which was Polkadot. We've got a link to the GitHub repository, a commit version, so we can identify the exact version of this code. And of course, a query API endpoint that I'll show you how to use in a minute. Down below, we've got the playground. This query here is from my cache. So if I run this, it probably won't work. It returns an empty data set. But if I go to the actual repository here, going to the homepage, scrolling down, you'll see I've got an example query to run. So I'm going to copy this. And let's go and paste it in here. And let's run this. And what happens is we don't get any data returning because at the moment we're just on 450 blocks or 480 now. And this is trying to synchronize from the beginning of time. So it's going to take quite a while before we get any real data. And there's actually a way to get around this because I'm actually not using the dictionary at the moment because I'm pointing to the Kusama endpoint with the dictionary pointing to production. So if I show you here, I'm pointing to this particular dictionary here, and if I look at the dictionary code, which we'll do, let's go back into Project Explorer and I do a search for dictionary. You'll see the Polkadot dictionary here. So my endpoint is pointing to this one instead of the Kusama dictionary, which is where I should be pointing to. So what happens is if I go back to my project dashboard and jump back into this, I can actually deploy another version where I'm not overriding the Kusama endpoint to show you what happens. And there's actually a bit of a trick here where I can actually promote this project into production, like so. And when I do this, what actually happens under the covers is the staging slot actually becomes production. So it's not like I'm now going to rebuild a new environment and call it production and then migrate the code. This staging slot actually becomes production. So just the name changes. So you'll see this. When I go promote to production, this says that the staging slot to production will seamlessly redirect traffic to minimize any downtime. The previous production slot will be replaced and deleted. So let's go promote. And there you go. There is no downtime because of how it works. And then I've got a free staging slot up here. Now, if I go ahead and deploy this, and I don't overwrite any of the endpoints, let's go deploy update. We can do a quick comparison, obviously, after this has fully deployed. So just sit tight, and again, we'll be back shortly. Right, so now we've got the staging slot up and running. Let's jump in and we'll do a quick comparison. First of all, we'll go to the production slot and we'll view this one here. And I'll run the query again. And we've got no data being returned. And in fact, the syncing at the moment has stopped. Let me go back and check out the staging slot with the dictionary. And you can see that all of a sudden we've got two entities already up to 29,000 blocks. And if I run my code, I've got data coming back already. So this is the main advantage of using a dictionary, because what it does is it doesn't go into every single block. It only grabs the block that has the data that it needs. And because of this, it is much faster. Okay, so that is how you can deploy a project into SubQuery Projects, or the hosted solution. Now, what I want to do here is show you how you can use this query endpoint to perform a query over, say, HTTP curl. I've got my terminal screen here. Let me increase this, and I can run curl and copy out this endpoint and paste it here. And then what I want to do next is use the D flag for data. And then I want to copy out this particular request and paste it in here. Let's go query equals, hit enter. And of course, you could format this nicely if you wanted to, but you can see here that the data, we've got some data coming back, and it actually equals what we see on screen. Let me run this again. There we go. And if I do a comparison, I've got 1976.81, 1976.81. So this first item here. And of course, if I go down below, I've got 72.100, which is 72.100 here. So using the curl command, you could include this in your, say, your web application and make a query to get the data to display in your mobile app, for instance. So there we have it, a video on how you can take a project, upload it into SubQuery Projects, run it inside Playground, and also promote the project to production as well. One thing to note, which I'll just quickly show you, is actually quite important to ensure you keep this nice and tidy. So very useful to delete the project here by deleting the staging slot. However, do note that you can't go into your production slot and delete this. If you want to delete this, then the way to do this is to go up top here and select Delete Project, deleting the entire project itself. So if I go yes to this, the project will be deleted and it's gone from my dashboard page. Great, hope that was useful, and I'll catch you on the next video.